Exmoor is a national park designated in 1953. It's an hilly open moorland, partly in North Devon. Named after the River Exe, which is central, it covers an area of 267.5 square miles. The cottage is on the eastern edge. Visitors mainly are colourful birds, but the arrival of Clever Ratty made them flee as he stole their food. Ilfracombe has long been a seaside resort. It was settled in the Iron Age by the Dumoniae Celts. From the 12th century, it comprised two distinct communities, farming and fishing. Ilfracombe has a very rocky beach. The landmark theatre beyond is a love or loathe it design, being topped by what look more like mini cooling towers instead of a conical design. A lifeboat was first bought in 1828. In 1866, the RNLI provided a shed. This present housing dates from 1996. As always, a lifeboat is voluntarily crewed by unpaid, dedicated local men. St. Nicholas Chapel on Lantern Hill has provided a beacon since 1361. It is the oldest lighthouse in Great Britain. The harbour with its little sandy beach is a natural formation. It became a port of refuge. In the absence of a sandy beach, the clean harbour and shore provides a small alternative, much enjoyed by children. In 1208, it provided King John with ships and men to invade Ireland, and was the last disembarkation point for forces sent to subdue the Irish. In 1247, a ship and men were sent to help conquer Scotland's Western Isles. Later, six ships and 79 men were sent to the siege of Calais. Activities far removed from today's relaxed holiday atmosphere. Many private businesses are aimed at the tourist trade, with a good number of eateries, from table service to windowsill, all of which are noted by the wildlife. bored old Dobbin is still providing a past century's way of exploring the town. Dominating the harbour approach is Heller's Barrow, dominant, unchanged. It would still be recognised by the Dumonii Celts, who built a hill fort there. Berrynarbour is a village, the last census recording a population of 749. St. Peter's Church dates from the 13th century, the tower from the 15th century, and the lych gate from the 17th century. Berrynarbour Village has won many awards, including Best Kept Village and Britain in Bloom. Its location borders Exmoor, being 3 miles east of Ilfracombe. It is named from Richard Berry, Lord of the Manor, from 1582 until 1645. The village is surrounded by dense woodland and farms. It is protected as an area of outstanding natural beauty. It is also the home for the flowerpot men. Combe Martin. The village nearest our base is 4 miles east of Ilfracombe. Its only street is 1.5 miles long, mythically the longest in Great Britain. At the western end is a sheltered cove with a small sandy beach. The cove proves ideal for inshore lifeboat rescue training. On the 15th of August 1952, 9 million tonnes of water crashed down the gorge, destroying much of Lynmouth. 35 deaths, 420 people homeless. 28 bridges badly damaged, 38 cars washed out to sea. This occurred previously in 1607 and 1796. Lynmouth lies on the northern edge of Exmoor, straddling the West Lynn and the East Lynn rivers, which flow down through a gorge 700 feet above sea level. The beach is a mass of large stones, whilst worth exploring after the tide has gone is useless for swimming. This visiting retriever, using his innate intelligence, sensibly decided to cool off. Lynmouth, in the words of artist Thomas Gainsborough, is the most delightful place for a painter this country can boast. Visitors arrive from many places to explore. To enjoy fine ale. And taste the quite often delightful fare. Lynmouth is connected to the neighbouring village of Lynn by a cliff railway.